We have a paper coming out in Science this week, and it's about the color and the feather configuration
on a small 130 million year old dinosaur called Microraptor from northeastern China.
What our new paper really shows is that this phenomenon that we call iridescence, which is a kind of both structural color as well as pigment color that we see in modern birds like grackles and like crows, evolved long before those animals did in non-avian dinosaurs. Now, whether this is a homologous, meaning that it was only one evolution or it evolved several times, we don't really know. We do know that it evolved several times in living birds, so that it may be just sort of a parallel evolution of this feature. But what it really shows is that these animals signaled visually a lot like living birds do today. Whenever we see a great specimen like this in a collection, we really try to think about what we can do with it that goes outside the ordinary. And this one had these beautiful feather impressions all over it. So one of the first things we thought we would do would be to look at, you know, feather coloration, because that's something which has been sort of the focus of a lot of different labs' work over the last couple of years. But another one is really like, you know, feather architecture and the configuration of feathers across the body, because there's been a lot of speculation about how the feathers were oriented in Microraptor, and whether or not that these formed airfoils, or whether or not that these had to do with something like, you know, sexual selection and sexual display. So I think that what we really nailed, and we conclusively have shown what color this animal was, that it was dark colored and it was iridescent. We've also shown that the tail feathers are in a different configuration than previously have been thought, that instead of just being sort of a lollipop single blade, there's actually two feathers that stick out pretty far on the end of the tail. And this is a common motif that one sees in lots of different, both birds alive today as well as fossil birds, and now in non-avian dinosaurs, that they have these almost peacock tail kind of things with these like long feathers sticking off the end of the tail that undoubtedly were used for display.
This work is really the result of a highly collaborative team of people spread across the planet in China, in the United States, and elsewhere, that we've really, you know, worked hard in putting this whole thing together to give us a really new look of an animal that was pretty poorly known until this.
My role was to do the imaging for the paper, and that included taking photographs of the specimen and mapping out the skeleton and ultimately doing a reconstruction, a drawing of the animal, how it may have appeared when it was alive. If you saw it today, superficially, you may think that you're looking at a crow-sized or a pigeon-sized bird, but you'd instantly know after that that this is something that's very unusual. It's very exciting to feel like I may be somewhat close to visualizing what this animal may have looked like.
One of the things that really drives me as a paleontologist is not necessarily the answer, it's the process. And when we look at something like a dinosaur, but has feathers on it, and it's preserved on a slab of rock, you know, one of the immediate things that you could think of is, wow, I wonder what color those feathers were. And just that we were able to put together a team of people to be able to figure that out is really what keeps me going as a scientist. I mean, it's less the answer, it's more the process.